It takes a swing at it and clears it. This will be icing to wave it off. 20 seconds to go. Clock ticking. And Klingberg stumbled. It's picked up by Bonino. He scores!
What a great job by the Predators. First of all, Sissons wins the draw off that neutral zone. Klingberg gets hit by the net there, loses a puck, and see him launch a stick. And Nick Bonino, he's going to take that one all day. Right there, took a tough route. His head was up, caught the post. Then Nick Bonino comes outside, gets the angle, right in the middle of the net.
The only time it really happened within the game was when McDavid went in and scored.
The throw fell down. Nugent Hopkins checked and they score.
It's the turnover. Hamonic up to Johnny Gaudreau. The stop up. He loses his footing. Yamamoto over. Now watch Shillington coming off the bench, and he does a great job coming back.
Let's see, we're going to get the call here.
After reviewing the play, the whistle was blown dead. The goalie was shoved into the net with the puck. That is not a good hockey goal.
That's Talbot getting away. Did get the shot. Scores! Oh, that was a tough break for Cam Ward.
First of all, Vallin does not get the puck deep. That creates the first problem for Carolina. And this shot will hit Babchuk's stick and absolutely fool Cam Ward on the knuckleball. And there it is, up, hits the stick off the tip of Cam Ward's glove.
Just getting to it ahead of Bozak. Patrick Marleau skating against Van Riemsdyk, and Dion Phaneuf just drilled Van Riemsdyk, and Van Riemsdyk slow to get up.
Oh!
Ouch.
Vinen looks for Aho on the weak side. Here comes Van Riemsdyk, fended off by Cogliano. A breakaway, Jakob Silfverberg's in, he scores! Out of nowhere, Jakob Silfverberg!
Ice conditions, last minute of a period.
Dumping, Mike, you're right. They miss it. That's a linesman's call to find that puck.
In front, it goes in! Was looking around, the puck snuck past Saros to tie the game at three. Bizarre.
Turn in a three-on-three into a four-on-three or any odd man situation you can. And
score! Konechny!
Schneider gets it. Palmieri loses an edge, and then Konechny
try to change up his
training
regimen.
Well, the word around the league is he's the toughest goaltender by far, and he might be one of the toughest guys in the National.
Look out! As that one gets away from Talbot and goes into the net.
When Ryan O'Reilly putting together an evening, everything's bouncing right for him. Goal and assist in the first period, and another one here just to chip in.
Now Irwin looks for some open ice. Got to the red line, fires it in. Predators will get a quick one. Oh, right in front! How did they get past Fiala? Smith was way out of the net.
Actually, Wellwood after it in center, but getting there first was Englund. Wellwood scores! Englund wipes out! And Eric Wellwood winds up with his first National Hockey League goal!
I think that'll be the last time that Englund ever does this. Oh my goodness! And Wellwood probably thought it was his birthday. All of a sudden, having that gift given to him.
On Shabbat and Zub. Mitch Marner winds in. Thornton, a centering pass. Matthews scores. Austin Matthews on the feed from Joe Thornton. Two on one. Boyd pulled. Shoot, scores.
Much that's happened for Jimmy Vesey so far.
Just a steal backhand shot. Batherson scores. Now a lead pass finds Kerfoot. Kerfoot, a centering pass. Score. Pierre Engvall snaps it by Hogberg. And it's 3-1 Leafs. There by Matthews, in comes Austin Matthews. A centering pass, great chance in front. Score! Joe Thornton knocked it in. Morgan Rielly to John Tavares. Back for Morgan Rielly. A centering pass, Matthews in long, shoot, scores! Austin Matthews gets his second. And it's 5-1 Toronto. Picked up by Watson in shorthanded. Shoots, rebound, score! Nick Paul, a shorthanded goal with 9 seconds to go in the period. Point reach it. Out of the box comes Zub. The foot pass ahead. Artem Zub on the breakaway. Zub in, scores! Shabbat works in. Feeds it back across. Tap back to White. Across to Brown. Scores! Back to Shabbat. Across he goes to Norris. Norris shoots. Tipped in front by Tkachuk. Rebound, score!
The puck will eventually be worked around for the Norris shot, and that rebound's going to pop up in the air.
Works it on Dadonov. In, holds. Hogberg down. And Marner couldn't slide it back. Now drops it back. Oh, what a chance there. Rielly turned away. Morgan Rielly lost the puck down to Shabbat. In comes Dadonov on the breakaway. Dadonov in, scores! And Dadonov, the overtime winner. And the Ottawa Senators come back from 5-1 down to win it 6-5.
He would have had a great chance to break them down and get a couple more power play shots.
Burakovsky in, he scores! Andre Burakovsky.
And he just pounds it. Delzato unlucky on the bouncing puck. Should be unassisted for number 65. Burakovsky and the Caps up 1-0 on the Flyers and Steve Mason.
Behind him and Eller will shovel it back down the ice.
That's an example of where Henrik has to be more selfish and shoot that puck at the net. Strangest goals you'll ever see in hockey. Now this is just bad luck. This is not Roberto Luongo's fault. It's nobody's fault. Just some bad luck.
Into right some skates and is played along now by Kyle Turris.
Great play by Janmark to delay the opportunity for Ellis to shoot that puck.
Pollock run into by Austin Watson, and a shot went through a cluster of players and a collision now. And down on the ice is one of the Predators. There'll be a penalty coming up.
Yeah, that's Ryan Ellis. It's down, Doc, and Corey Perry got a load of him. Ellis down and just finally getting back to his feet. Yes, a right elbow by Corey Perry. And
Corey Perry is gone.
Number 10, 5 in game for Alboy.
Alexander Radulov, the former Nashville Predator, will serve the penalty to Corey Perry.
Early in the Winter Classic, an injured Predator, an enormous opportunity for his team.
Trying to get back in. Of course not. We're only first period in.
Whoa, and Brizgalov thrown out in front of the score. Ilya Brizgalov shows he will not be on the Russian gymnastics team.
Instead of just letting his man come back, he gets the puck. Down he goes.
He was in the no goalie zone anyway.
He's got a great moves, too. I like the way he goes in.
Here he comes, Dennis Wiedemann. Fakes it in, he got knocked down by the goaltender. He had a wide open net. Actually, he just lost his balance.
Jonathan Toews, hard up the boards. Teravainen tipped the puck. Bishop's up the play, ran into his own net. Patrick Sharp scores!
Sharp never needed a goal more than that. 13 games without, and he gets an absolute gift.
Win it for the Kings. If Brown scores, the Kings win. Here's Dustin Brown. And a save. And we go to the fourth round.
I think Brown actually did a pretty good job just to get his stick on it. Fake, he loses it, but he does get to whack at it. He still had it, but by that time, the goaltender, Collins, had the pad there.
Mike Yeo rolling through the lines as well. Good field in this one so far. Petrangelo in, scores!
Down low, the Blues get in on real big bodies, and this puck just gets shoveled out to the front, and there's nobody there. I mean, that's the puck's just moving extremely slow towards Petrangelo, and he just fires this wrist shot as Montoya loses his foot.
It's Yzerman! Oh, he just couldn't finish it off as Wall was down. Yzerman in front again, another chance, and a big stop, and the puck's in! Wall had it and dropped it, and Detroit scores first for the first time.
Patrick Wall just got caught hot-dogging. Believe me, he was going to give it the how do you do, and he dropped the puck. I'm not so sure he was giving it the old, look what I got. Let's have a... Yep.
So the Blues leading 1-0 after one round. Shen 25% in his career. Could put the Blues in a big advantage here. He swings wide and he lost the puck. And no shot attempt.
But obviously for the player, he's like, oh my goodness gracious. And he's going up against his buddy Kemper, who might have said something on the way by.
Comes up to handle the puck. It's scary, isn't it? A lot of people stop breathing on the Ducks bench. Set him. Oh! He got tied up and lost his stick!
Slide his stick out from his blocker,
and he draws
his right hand, and he dropped it. And it hit his stick Karam back through the legs, and you can see his reaction. That is one of the most embarrassing moments ever.
Watch this. I bet you he could try that 10 times in practice and never even execute it on the right angle.
Colin Miller swooping behind his own cage, flushed out by Tom Wilson. Turnover! Score! Jacob Vrana!
Jake the Snake, Hopper 10, the goaltender sitting deep. He's not moving up because the Sabres have control. Isolation on Stahl, the bad giveaway.
So now it's Hornquist, Gensel, and Crosby to begin this game. As Brandon Davidson is in, he spins it on goal, but stumbling backward was Tristan Jarry. The puck in as bizarre a fashion as you could find, the Islanders have a 1-0 lead.
And take a look at Tristan Jarry. I don't know if he's expecting that that puck is going to be dumped in or not, but he is totally confused and catches an edge, can't get his balance. The puck goes off the back bar on a backhand.
Kisnichin with two Islanders on him. Karen back to center. Markov got it to Kovalev. He fell down. Norton was taken down.
What are they calling a penalty for?
I don't know. On the puck,
that's what I thought.
And oh, it's going to be a goal. That's a goal. O'Byrne put it into his own net. The game is tied. Unbelievable.
I can't imagine he's going to pass it back to his goalie in that situation.
Here to the side is Brower skating to the bench under his own power. Oh, and then he's run into there by Johansson, who didn't see him, and Johansson is injured. Oh, my.
Now I've seen everything. Like, Troy Brower was blinking. Like, he was barely functioning coming back to the bench. He's still sitting on the bench there, and he zigged right into Johansson. Here's the hit by Jackman. He's well away from the boards, but he's leaning forward, and you can see the way in which he goes into the boards. He's able to turn his head. Look at the left side of your screen. Johansson is looking backwards, expecting a pass.
For Marlowe. Marlowe stops. Juice. Stopped by Bossois. Another chance. They score. Nazem Kadri.
And Chris Russell scores on his own net. Turns, tries to clear the puck. He turns and shoots, and he puts it by Laurent Bossois. That's just a tough, tough goal.
Blocked and it leads to the Sharks coming back the other way. Suter into the zone. Centering pass, gloved out of midair by Bergevin. How long did he have that puck in his glove? Now the puck's in the net! The puck is in the net! But the question is, how did it get there? There's Bergevin. That's where I thought he had it. Oh, he did!
He did. He threw it right in his own goal.
He threw it in his own net!
Oh, my.